In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you my voicing methods. First of all, the guide tones in the right hand and the roots in the left hand. So we've got the chord of D minor 7, G7, and C major 7. The top note is the 7th, the lower note is the 3rd. In the next chord, we move the top note to B, which is now the 3rd of G, but we keep the 7th, and then we move the 7th down to E, which is the 3rd of C. To make this chord richer, I'm going to add a 9th, so that's an E on the top of this chord of D minor. Sounds like that. Then I'm going to do exactly the same movement that I did in the guide tones, but leaving the E at the top, which is the 13th, and then moving it down to play the 9th of C. So that was still the same as before. Now I've just added some flavouring. So I have an analogy, which is it's like making a cake. So in order to make a cake, you need to have some basic ingredients, such as egg, flour, and sugar and such. And then we're adding a little cherry on top, so that's the E, just to give it some flavouring. If you want a slightly thicker chord, you can add the 5th, which is the A. You leave it there for the next chord, and now you've got the 9th of G there, 13th at the top, and the guide tones the 7th and the 3rd. And then the resolution can be, which is a nice 6-9 chord. So we have 3, 6, or the 13th, the major 7th, and the 9th. Three note voicing. Or the last chord could be this, which is just the 3rd, the 5th, the 7th, and the 9th. You can also do those in the left hand, and they would be rootless voicings. So the first one would be, or, which would leave your right hand to improvise over that. The next voicing is the same as the first one with the guide tones. I'm just inverting them. So you've got the 7th at the bottom, the 3rd at the top. This moves down. So now it moves down to the 3rd of G, the 7th of G, of C. Now I'm going to add a cherry or whatever topping you like, and that's going to be an A at the top, which is the 5th. I'm going to leave it there, so that becomes the 9th of G, and then I'm going to move them down, which has got a nice C major 7 there with the 7th, the 3rd, and the 5th. Just do that again. And again, movement is still the same as with the guide tone. I'm going to add an extra bit of topping to this voicing. So I'm going to add the 9th, that could be our jam filling. So we've got D minor 9, 7, 9, 3, 5, G7, 3, 13, 7, 9. Try those in all 12 keys, and you could also try playing them in the left hand. That's quite low to do it there, and that might be a little bit high, so that probably is not such a great one. That's better, that sits better with the left hand. It would be if you're improvising in the right hand. So 12 keys, both hands. That should keep you going for a while.